And welcome to GigaCAD Play Studio Tutorials. In this tutorials we're going to create this image with a terrain cracked terrain add kind of like fog looking between on the lower right here areas, overall clouds and atmospheric effect. As well, we'll do some guard rays, add an additional enhancement and colors and sharpness inside the Photoshop. So let's begin. Okay, so let's start working. And first, what I'm going to do is work on terrain. So I'm going to create procedure fractal terrain first. I'll just leave it even same default size as came. Next, we'll go to edit objects. We probably don't need it the brush for this. And next, what I want to do, I want to actually make edgeless. So we'll uncheck edges right here. Next, let's reset this function and we'll go work inside the function to create kind of interesting effect. One thing what I want to do, I want to create somewhat like a cracks almost looking, and for that we're actually going kind of noise, and we'll go to let's see, flat pattern, line patterns right here, cracks. So this is what we're going to use. Okay, let's create, let's connect our altitude to this. Okay, right here, and we can preview. This is our cracks. They don't look very good right now. Very look mechanical, kind of not natural look at all. First things first, let's reduce size. Okay, maybe a little bit more. Okay, next, let's go ahead add turbulence node. And we'll connect to our turbulence node as well. Let's do increase amplitude here. So we have it kind of, you see, a little bit more look natural, less of this distortion. As well, we can go and increase just crack width a little bit bigger. Okay, right here. Okay, so we have a nice effect, but they may be a little bit too tall. And I see right here effect applied, so we need kind of reduce them. And we have it several ways. We can do this with a filter. And this is just the one we can create filter and take kind of down, you know, right here, overall bring this maybe even lower, so like this, or we can multiply. We have multiple ways to do it, so let's do right now with filter. It's kind of easiest way. Again, if you want it, you can see we can create this way, which is look kind of very interesting as well. Okay, but again, we'll do edgeless for this moment. So we'll set that one. Next, I actually want to apply something more interesting texture to this. So for that, we'll create a fractal and we'll switch to terrain fractal. We'll go modify for this terrain, the meta scale to 3 and large features to 3 as well. And let's go ahead and connect this with a blender together. Okay, you can see right here by applying we had this nice effect already. However, in the blender we have several choices. We can do multiply, so it will bring kind of the bottom one, or set max, or let's go to add. So I think add probably will work a little bit better in this case, so we can just go over all up and down, and we can move a little bit more towards, okay, where's my add, right here. So we'll kind of apply a little bit more effect on the size, okay, maybe even more. Okay, and let's go inside this filter and bring it a little bit more down. Okay, right here. So we'll take this top. And we'll have it, but not that high. Okay, right here we have a beautiful cracks. We can actually go ahead create one external dependency if we needed to use it and connect to the cracks, so we know it is kind of cracks, we can reuse it. We'll click OK, and right here this kind of our terrain already done. We'll go and select main camera, bring a little bit up, and let's look down. So right here is our distress kind of terrain with all of those things going down there. if it's little bit too large cracks, we always can go, or for example, piece is too big, we can go inside, and by here we can reduce scale, make a little bit more details. Okay, let me actually check with my camera. So my camera is located from this side, and I think I may need rotate from right here. From this point will be a little bit better. So I take this one, hold down shift and just rotate. Okay, because I think this is maybe angle is a little bit better. We always can change, or maybe it is. Let me rotate all the way right here. So I kind of look how the angle going. Okay, we'll go take our camera. Okay, let's bring right here and preview. Okay, I think we ready for first preview our terrain. Okay, and you can see we have an interesting cracks going. So let's next apply some materials for our terrain. And I want to apply just simple rock and plants for this. Okay, next I want to apply some green stuff on top. So we'll go to mixed materials. Actually, sorry, simple. We'll go add layers. We don't want simple for this one. Mix it. We'll just take a grass. Let's click OK. Set to zero right here. We'll go to environment. And I want to actually set this on the top and a little bit higher. Okay, as well, we can add small fuzzy kind of effect. Okay, let's preview. So we have a nice side right here, almost look like a grass. Next, we can add ecosystem. Nice ecosystem will take pre-settings, what we already applied. We'll just need to go ahead and add some plants to this. And let's add maybe another late spring and some of the Scottish pine tree. So we'll go add them right here. Let's click populate. Yeah, I'm just go populating on this. No, I just want populate. I know that my computer can handle. It just depends how much memory you have it on yours. Also, I want to actually take presence and maybe even cut right here from the bottom. So we'll go on the top. Maybe a little bit more. We'll go density. Pop up a little bit more. Okay, let's click preview. So right here we have kind of nice trees going all over places. So this kind of distressed. To next, add a little bit dimension to this. What we need to add, we need to add fog on a ground kind of. And we can have it several ways to do. The one actually interesting way to do is by using water. So we can take water, we can bring all the way up. And I notice we have some plants right here on the bottom. So let me go right here, take my presence and increase even more. So I don't want plants on the bottom at all. Even more. Okay, right here. So we have it our water. See? Okay, right here you can see around. And we can actually modify this water to look a little bit more interesting. So first, I want to work with foam. And I'll go select foam and create just purling noise. Next, we'll go with default value, water, go inside the transparency, and we'll just go reset this to all the way white colors. Okay, so let's go ahead and reset this one as well to white. Okay, and we can also take this depth and kind of reducing. Okay, so actually, you know what, let's even create maybe more engines to take this color. Maybe even kind of greenish. darkish, like this color. So we're going to create, let's pop up this to 10 meters. Probably even less reflection. Okay, we'll leave it everything as a default. Let's go increase a little bit more on the highlights. Okay, and maybe do highlights. And the bumps, we actually want to go pop up all the way. So this will be much higher bumps on this one. Okay, the one actual most important thing is we'll go inside the effect and want to take luminosity and pop up all the way up to 80. So this is will create a very interesting kind of like lighting, somewhat very soft fog effect right there. You can see already right on the edges, and it's how we going to simulate a little bit. We can always take this increasingly bit more. Oops, just let's go maybe, just example, set to 20 meters. And you can see right these edges will have a little bit more interesting effect, kind of depth. But in this is way going to kind of faking this interesting fog, distance fog. So we'll go take a camera, let me actually move it. Maybe more a little bit this way. And just readjusting. Okay, maybe need to add a little bit more trees to this area. So let me do these things. Go right here. Go to present. Let's click populate. See, yeah, we'll add nicely. Trees, you know what, maybe even pop up density even higher. Okay, as, oops, not this one. But scaling, shrink, a little bit influence. Yeah, I think this is, okay, look nice. Okay, we'll go click OK. Next, I think we can start work on atmosphere. Before this, let's go click preview. And you can see, don't worry about this water on the back, but you can see right here, this is what I'm looking for. And this is look very nice, almost like a fog right between areas. Of course, we can go take, bring it a little bit even higher. Okay, let's take camera readjusting. Can preview one more, so we have it nice. And you see how this is simulating, because very nice effect right here. I don't worry about this area, because we're going to have a distance fog and everything, so that will be gone. Okay, now let's look on work on atmosphere, and we'll go with the light. We'll say to global radiosity for this. I'm going to add lighting, no, maybe more saturated actual on the ambient light. We'll skip for a second clouds, but we're going to our sky, make as well darker, more saturated, and we'll take a fog and bring fog quite a bit high, as well as the haze, and just a little bit more on glowing effect. So let's see this one, and also I want to add this distance effect, so we'll take aerial perspective, pop up that one as well. So I'll give it us kind of effect, and we'll see in a second we maybe actually take him down. So we'll go play with those values. Then next, let's go ahead and add cloud, and then we'll add just darker canvas. We'll take drop them to 0 meters, so it will be all the way to the ground. But I want to bring this top to the camera level, so we'll bring maybe a little bit higher like this. Okay, we'll go pop up details amount. Let's increase altitude variation, so give it us a nice cover going over. I need to look after how it will apply it, but we also can take density and bring density quite a bit down and details. So let's see. It's kind of what's happened when you start adding, you kind of playing with this and see how it will come up. Let's go click to preview. So we can see right here we have a nice clouds. We maybe want to take these clouds even reduce even more on the amount, but they cover very good on the distance and nice with this water. Actually, it's look like almost below, so we don't want too much of these clouds. So we want to decrease maybe cover, decrease a little bit less right here. Okay, next we'll take sunlight, and we'll take sun and put it actually up front of the camera right here, so it will give it us effect. And again, every time when you put sun up front of the camera, it will add this extra glowing effect to all atmosphere. So whatever we have there, it start glowing a little bit more. Okay, and this point maybe we'll start increase and see how well that will overall will affect our. And like I say, remember right here we won't see it because we kind of start having this glow effect and it just start kind of be lost in this moment. So let's go take atmosphere editor. Okay, right here, maybe, you know, just decrease a little bit more the clouds, pop up and take the density a little bit down. And it, because we do have this, we want to increase just slightly with the cover. Yeah, I think this is look kind of nice coming up. Okay, let's take our glowing actually all down, see what we happen here, as well as reducing a little bit more on the haze and the fog, and a little bit just overall see what this will give it us higher contrast, so it'll bring us more details. Okay, and let's click on preview so we can see with atmosphere how it will look. You can see we lost some of this nice beautiful glow, so what you want to back, and maybe a little bit too many of the clouds, we don't want to overwhelm that much. So let's take reduce cover. Okay, we'll take a pop up back our glowing. Okay, maybe just increase a little bit of haze and take it darker as well. I think our sun, it go just slightly down, so we'll have this more saturated kind of almost like sun look inside the lens. Okay, let's take our actual camera, move just a little bit up and bring it down as well. So we have a nice line right here on the horizon. Okay, we'll go take also clouds, just reduce them slightly down. Okay, let's take a camera. Sun position, we'll go take even a little bit more down. Okay, let's go to atmosphere editor and tweak a little bit more. So the light, actually, let's do from saturated drop down to less saturated. Okay, we'll leave it all the same. We'll go inside the clouds and okay, on the clouds we have it zero, so it's about right height, about right. We can maybe pop this back, you know, to the scale just slightly back to this one. Okay, we have it our density here, our opacity, let's get it 200% on the opacity. Okay, sharpness, fineness, details pop up a little bit higher, we're good right here. Okay, and our sky and fog, this sky, you know what, let's make it same, less saturated, so it will give it us more kind of yellowish color to our atmosphere. So kind of right here you can see haze is starting giving this some sunset yellowish type. Okay, a little bit compensated for this one. As well, you know what, I'm going to reset this to maybe brighter, and we'll pop up higher. So let's see, should give us a nice effect, nice haze, kind of glowing effect. Yeah, so this, excellent. Okay, right here, because we increase this haze, I want to reduce by decreasing this scattering, so it's how particles will start glowing, so we reduce on that one. Okay, we'll pop up back this one, increase, it's maybe around 9. Okay, let's click and preview. Okay, so we start having nice effect. I think clouds work very well with this. Okay, maybe take right here some small clouds. Add to this point. But I think this is look actually not bad at all. So we'll take our cloud, bring up, increase. Okay, next let's modify, we'll increase amount of the presence, so we'll go drop it down, populate, so we'll have it more trees. Okay, let's increase density. Okay, we'll take our sunlight, bring even a little bit more down, and increase softness. So let's give it a nice effect. And I still kind of see these big blobs of the clouds. So I want to kind of rework these ones. Okay, right here. You know, maybe even still decreasing. We can increase opacity and let's give it a little bit more heaviness, which I don't want to do, or density. So I want to actually make them very light, it's about 2 maybe. Okay, let's take cloud here, and we can always just readjust manually as well. So if for some reason something doesn't lay it properly, or maybe I don't like where's this one, like it, I can move to create better looking right here area. We can also after maybe going and add some sun rays going around. I think it's good for now, so let's go ahead, set final, and again I will render on the resolution for our tutorial, but you can go higher. Actually, before I do this, let's be sure our sky at least set to 0 quality boost, so we reduce a little bit on the grayness of this, and I'm going to render this image, pause tutorial, and I will come back when the render is completed. So right here we have our image done. It took a little bit over an hour, and you can see we have a very beautiful effect with the fog, like almost on this cracking land, that you can modify if you want. You can create different type of peaks with, but what I was going after, it's this kind of water effect on the bottom, you can see, which working almost like a fog somewhere lower effect, so it's give it this kind of interesting combination effect. Next, what I want to do, I want to actually enhance and add maybe some guard rays right here, and I want to use this in Photoshop. So let's go ahead, save this image as PSD Photoshop format or TFF, and open inside the Photoshop. Okay, so we are inside the Photoshop, and again this will be our, if we click full resolution, we have it kind of smooth. I don't see that much grain. Again, we can pop up maybe a little bit better, but overall it's a nice effect. I maybe want to increase a little bit more contrast, but mostly what I want to do is creating this guard rays coming maybe from this point from the sun. So let's do a couple things. First, what I want to do, it is creating brightness and contrast adjustment layer, and I want just play around a little bit, see what's happening if we just decrease a little bit brightness, bring a little bit down. So right here you can see it's just slightly the adjustment. Okay, and also right here we start having kind of effect losing. So let's do go inside mask for this and maybe remove a little bit from top. So I'm going select brush, we'll increase size, just normal brush, intake capacity maybe about 14. Just start, you know, right here a little bit painting, and you can see it's become a little bit smoother. So overall increase a little bit brightness. Okay, so let's kind of, this is balanced, or maybe go back, but I think when we add some lighting to these rays, it may increase kind of interesting. So for that one, we'll go create a new layer. Okay, next, let's go to the filter and we'll just set be sure with black, white, go filter, render, and we render the clouds. Then next, I want to render. Actual clouds probably will work just fine. I want to adjust. We'll go to brightness contrast for this. We'll pop up contrast just a little bit more. Okay, we can also add level, or maybe we just modify curves. And actually don't want to modify as layer. I will modify straight on this one. So we go to image adjustment. Let's go to take levels and just add a kind of a little bit more contrast this way, clipping. Okay, so next we'll go to filter, blur, and we'll go to set. Okay, we can add motion blur, but actually, I think be. On this one, we want you to use it to radial blur. Okay, we'll go to zoom, go all the way up right here, increase amount, and let's set to the best quality. So I want to do a lot, and I want to do right here, just on the top. Let's click OK. You can see we have a nice going effect, and we just need to switch this to the soft light. So you can see right here we have a nice rays coming. Again, if this is rays for some reason a little bit too big, we can also modify in creating other ones by okay, let's go to filter, noise. We can add noise. Okay, let me first add mask. Actually, probably better if we do filter render first. Go to clouds, next filter, noise, add noise this way. Okay, I'll go to monochromatic. So let's add that much. We'll go next again, filter, blur. We'll go again to right on blur. It will have the same settings. We'll click OK. And we'll set this to the soft light as well. So you can see we have it. Smaller rays and big rays, combine them together, it's giving us nice effect. We can go ahead and just maybe even reduce some of that right here. Just create a little bit smaller effect lines, but combine with them, we have a bigger and smaller rays, so it's giving it nice effect at this point. Okay, next things what I want to do, it's creating just slightly color balance. Okay, and let's see overall if we want to create, let's start with the shadows, and we can create a little bit colder look or greener. So I think the colder maybe will add a little bit slighter contrast in this case. Okay, with the cyan, again it's for the shadows, we'll go for the mid-tones. And let's set a little bit more, maybe kind of warmish. And we'll go on highlights. And on the highlights, probably more to the red. Kind of. So we have this nice color gradients going. Again, right here you can see we modified with our colors adjustment. So let's give it nice contrast. I do like also overlay, and we'll see if details, increase details maybe better. So for this Control Shift Alt E, we'll create, combine all those layers below and create a new one. And I'm going to switch this to, we'll go other, high pass. And right here we'll add edges, 0.7, little bit lower. So I'll click one. You can see kind of pop up edges at this point. We'll go set to overlay. Okay, right here you can see we kind of added sharpness to our trees. Again, we can modify it, try to adjust. Okay, maybe about 70. Okay, next what I want to do is maybe add a little bit coloring to this, and we can do this actually with creating new layer. We'll go to edit, fill. We'll go fill with 50% gray. Okay, and next we'll switch this to soft light. Okay, and we'll use just two brushes, normal, with the opacity maybe about 10, to dark or light up some areas. So for example, right here, I'm just want to touch up some small areas. Just dark up. Okay, we'll combine. I'll just add some areas, another effect. Just give it a little bit dimension to our scenery. So as an example, you can see just slightly add some dimensions. But again, if you go into more details, you can do this way. And next up, again, creating combining new layer by pressing Shift Control Alt E on the PC. And I'm going to actually using Filter Forge to look enhance some with the contrast and sharpness by using. Most likely this will be actually using kind of like this filter with overlay, but I'm also looking on the sky how much it will affect. Okay, so probably something more this filter, I kind of like how it's layout. So I'll go to apply this one. Okay, we have an effect right here. I don't like necessarily sky, how it's applied, but I do like how it's applied a little bit better on the bottom. So to fix this, again, we'll do with a mask. Okay, we'll set the mask here. We'll just pop up higher, so it will do faster. And we'll increase. We'll just start painting around this area. Kind of bring in closer, and you can see effect we're applying kind of on the bottom ones a little bit better looking. So just create this effect, and again we can just go a little bit slider in. So we have this nice gradient apply, interesting effect to our image. Again, we can go now layer again, and I like to preserve, so we preserve, we can go back if we needed each step and recreate it. In this case, actually, we can pop up details, and let me see actually if this will give it nice effect. And I created group, go, oops, actually I'm going to the group and set this to overlay. I'll go to this one, add as a vivid light, invert, and let's filter blur. We'll set to the surface blur. So I want to see if amount of details will affect. So let's go set threshold a little bit higher. And as well as a radius pop-up a little bit higher. Maybe pop-up radius up and reduce threshold to 6. So we overall, yeah, probably threshold 7, and let's try this to 12. So we have a little bit higher details. Again, you can see how it's add, but it's also bring a little bit more of the grain. But I do like it. It's what I'm going more for illustration, more coming up. And again, right here we can see. I do like right here effect, but a bit too strong on the bottom. So we'll fix in this by creating mask. Again, taking this and just slightly adding and fixing right here on the bottom. Okay, so it's come up. I think it's kind of look very interesting at this point. Okay, let's create one more color balance, and this is just overall. I want to see, not necessarily using this layer, but I want to see what other ones, if we're using different colors, how much it will affect. Actually doesn't look good, so you can see how much you can go around and modifying, playing around with the colors and have a different effect. I think we're done right now with this one. I'll just erase, create new again layer, and going to sharpen this one with unsharp mask. Okay, just slightly right here, and I think we're done. Okay, except we can create curves. Okay, we can take our curves, bring all the way down. Okay, we'll take probably from right here. I'm going to create frame. Okay, maybe around. Okay, we'll take black, fill up with the black. And next we'll just take mask, pop up feathering, and set this to the soft light. So you can see, kind of give this more effect of the light dissipating. Okay, and then next last step, before we save it, we'll go create another layer vibrance, so we can pop up a little bit more saturation and vibrance in this image. There you go. Okay, and you can see we had a very nice, interesting image. Of course, I noticed just right here we have it a little bit more, so we can add some of the smoothness to this point right here, blur. So it's kind of take this edge because clouds, how those coming up. But overall we add nicely done right here with clouds effect filter, and we have this going some focus on the end. So you can change probably shape if you want to create interesting, but overall this is different type of illustrations. Hopefully it will help you to explore and try to different going way when you work with Vue. Thank you for watching these tutorials from Geekit Play Studio. Please remember, visit us on the web is www.geekitplay.com.